Salut, salut. This is the audio file for week 6, leçon numéro 1. Semaine 6, leçon numéro 1. Here, we will learn how to turn a sentence affirmative or negative into a question in French. 2 weeks ago, we learned how to turn an affirmative sentence into a negative one. And today, we're learning how to ask questions in French. On your screen, you have right now a sentence. Tu manges une banane. You are eating a banana or you eat a banana. How to turn this into a question in French? Well, one thing I would like to mention is that I'm not gonna, the question I'm about to ask will not target the subject, so it won't be who. It won't target the object either, so it won't be what do you eat. And it won't be about the time or the place or the cause or the quantity, how much, how many, nope. It will be a question that targets the verb itself, the action itself. And in English, it will be, do you eat a banana? And you will answer, yes, I do, or no, I don't. So how do we do this in French? Well, it's very easy. There are several ways of doing this, and we'll be studying only 2 ways here, the easiest ones. The first one is the est-ce que expression. Est-ce que is very simple to use. All you have to do is add est-ce que at the beginning of your affirmative sentence or negative sentence and add your question mark. So here, our affirmative sentence was tu manges une banane. The question will be est-ce que tu manges une banane? Est-ce que tu manges une banane? Alright? If the question, the sentence was a negative one, tu ne manges pas une banane, it will be est-ce que tu ne manges pas une banane? If it was, tu ne manges jamais de banane, it would be, est-ce que tu ne manges jamais de banane? So all you have to do is add, est-ce que at the beginning of your original sentence. If the subject is il or elle, in this case, you will have to remove the e of que in est-ce que. So it will sound est-ce qu'il ne mange pas? Or est-ce qu'elle ne mange pas? Instead of saying est-ce que elle ne mange pas? Or est-ce que il ne mange pas? You will say est-ce qu'il ne mange pas? Or est-ce qu'elle ne mange pas? Again, you make the liaison, you make the connection between those two words. Two vowels together in contact in French usually it doesn't work. So you will one of them will have to disappear, and in this case, the e of que will disappear, and you will add this comma above the apostrophe, and you will sound est-ce qu'il, est-ce que, est-ce qu'elle. Sorry, est-ce qu'il or est-ce qu'elle. All right, this happens whenever the subject begins with a vowel. All right, okay. The other way of doing this was by inverting the order subject and verb. The affirmative sentence is has this order: subject plus verb plus object. Tu manges une banane. Tu as a subject, mange as the verb, and then une banane as the object. Now all we have to do is to invert the order, so it will be verb, subject, and object. Manges-tu une banane? Manges-tu une banane? And you add a dash between them. And don't forget again the question mark at the end. So, manges-tu une banane? Alright, easy, right? Now, if the subject in the sentence was il, like il mange une banane, he eats a banana, il or elle, she eats a banana, elle mange une banane, what do you do? Do you say mange elle une banane, just like we explained? I mean, if you invert subject and verb, would you say mange elle une banane? No, you will have to do a little modification here. You will add a dash, then t, and then another dash between the verb and the subject. So it will be mange-t-il une banane or mange-t-elle une banane? This is made simply to ensure embarrassed sound, nothing else. No proper, there is no particular grammatical function of the dash t dash. All right. And again, this will happen whenever the subject is ill or ill. And I should say, and whenever the verb does not end in T or D. If your verb ends in E, in a T or D, do not add dash T dash, because the D and the T at the end of the verb will already be able to make the connection with the subject. So two ways: use the dash T dash first when the subject is ill or ill, singular or plural, okay, ill or ill, and use it also when the verb does not end in T or D, like finitil, does he finish, or prend-il, does he take. Prend ends with a D, and you don't need to add the dash T dash. Just put the dash in between the verb and the subject to have your question, okay? But if the verb using does not end with a T or a D, in this case, add dash T dash when the subject is ill or ill, all right? What happens then when the subject is je, in this case, like je mange une banane? Would you say mange-je une banane? No. Simply use the est-ce que formula. Est-ce que je mange une banane? Est-ce que je mange une banane? This will happen whenever the verb that you use is belongs to the first group, ER. And we already learned those verbs. Parler, manger, demander, all verbs ending in ER except aller. Okay? If the subject is je, do not invert. It will not work. So you should not say mange-je. Again, it's all about the sound. It will sound really bad. So instead, say, you should say, est-ce que je mange une banane? Okay. And this is only for verbs that ends in er and whose subject is je. Okay. So in this case, je mange. Manger is a verb of the first group ending in ER. You shouldn't say mange-je to ask a question. Nope, that's not French. Say est-ce que je mange? Okay, est-ce que je mange? And this is for the je subject only. Now, what happens when you use an actual name? Like Tom mange une banane. Tom eats a banana. What happens if you need to invert verb and subject? What do you do? Would you say mange Tom une banane, like we did with the personal pronoun? Would you say mange Tom une banane? No, do not do this. What you should do instead is use Tom at the beginning of your sentence, then the verb, then dash T dash il une banane. So Tom mange-t-il une banane? If it was Véronique, a girl, it would be Véronique mange-t-elle une banane. If the subject was nous, let's say it was a group of people in which I was included, right? I would say, ma famille et moi mangeons-nous une banane? Ma famille et moi, my family and I, do my family and I eat a banana? Yeah, that's my family and I don't really know. Do my family and I, or do my family and I eat a banana? So, as you can see here, we simply need to add the actual name, then the verb, then dash T dash. It's a little bit complex here to explain on YouTube in only 10 minutes. So feel free to join my virtual class, where you will have the written lesson and you will have it on your computer, download it on your computer, and you will spend more time learning it. But now it's kind of, and I'm kind of exhausted now, okay? So have fun, and I see you in about 4 days. Right, bye bye, au revoir, merci.